Well, there is a major construction project underway here in the Commonwealth that many Kentuckians have never heard about.
It's a multi-billion-dollar undertaking aimed at destroying some of the most dangerous chemical weapons on the planet. WLKY Steve Bergen has been investigating. Here's what he discovered.
Those chemical weapons are stored south of Lexington in Madison County, and they should have been destroyed years ago.
This community has babysat this very dangerous material for over 40 years.
Craig Williams is with a watchdog organization called the Chemical Weapons Working Group, and he's talking about GB and VX. Right now, construction is underway on a disposal facility located just yards from earthen igloos where GB and VX are stored at the Bluegrass Army Depot. Williams describes those weapons as bug spray for humans.
It is made to do the same thing to human beings as Raid or some other bug spray does to insects.
Mustard gas projectiles are also stored at the Bluegrass Army Depot. They arrived in the 1940s. According to Williams, for years the Army demanded destruction by incineration, which caused a 10-year project delay. Citing environmental concerns, his group fought incineration. Finally, the Pentagon agreed to chemical neutralization. The 523 tons stored in the Commonwealth represents only 2% of the nation's chemical weapons stockpile. Most of it already has been destroyed. The Bluegrass Army Depot is the last of 9 locations in the U.S. to get a disposal facility. It is scheduled to be finished in mid-2015 at a cost of $1.8 billion. But that's only a fraction of the total expense.
The total life cycle cost, that's the cost from the beginning of the project through destruction of the chemical weapons and then plant closure, is estimated to be approximately $5.5 billion.
When the job is done, the disposal facility will be destroyed along with anything else that has come in contact with those weapons. While the communities of Berea and Richmond, located along Interstate 75, have been living for decades next to some of the most dangerous chemicals on Earth, lifelong residents like Richmond Mayor Jim Barnes says they have not been living in fear.
What goes up down the interstate probably just as bad. We just don't know about it.
It is the same feeling echoed by attorney and Berea Mayor Steve Connolly. Generations of families have benefited from the presence of the Bluegrass Army Depot. Connolly says his city's safety also has been greatly improved.
Largely because of the existence of the depot, we have a top flight early warning system, which really gets used most because of weather issues, tornadoes, storms.
Berea and Richmond are both benefiting from a multi-billion dollar project at a time when the country continues to pull itself out of a recession.
If there's an economic positive that comes out of now getting rid of it, this community deserves to realize that benefit.
Local officials are already planning for the project's end. Plant closure is set for some time in 2026. There's concern the economic boom will turn into an economic bust.
One of our discussions now is what level of service do we want for our community and what level can we afford when the depot's gone.
What happens when you have 1,500 people just leave your community? And I'm not saying they all will, you know, but, where do you find jobs for them?
Again, the total cost, start to finish, $5.5 billion. To put that number in perspective, building the downtown and East End bridges will run just over $1.6 billion. Steve Bergen, WLKY News.